Good evening, friends, and welcome. Today, I want to talk a little bit more about pipes. About pipes, grain, and polish, to be exact. You will remember when last time we spoke, our topic were pipes and what I like about them. Now, you may remember that back then I mentioned one characteristic that is, to me, particularly important when it comes to pipes, and it is a certain way in which the surface of a pipe reflects the light, and that property of the surface, which I mean is iridescence in a broader meaning, or as it is known in woodworking, chatoyance. Chatoyance, or chatoyancy, which is a term which originated in gemology, means the effect that the grain of the wood is made to appear nearly three-dimensional because of the fact that it seems as if different layers that are beneath the surface reflected the light in different ways. Maybe I should just show you some examples here. This nice 2009 Dunhill, I think, shows quite clearly what I mean, especially here around the rim. Vibrant and alive when moved in the light. Also here on this pipe by Portuguese carver Reis, João Reis. It wouldn't seem entirely inappropriate to say that this grain has a sense of depth to it, and it almost seems to change its appearance. Not only because of the glossy surface, but also behind that. It has this kind of nice, almost wet look to it, that is also, especially in this combination, reminiscent with certain snail shells or the shell of a nautilus. Here, maybe you can get another look at the depth that seems to appear and seems to be going around here, depending on how the pipe is lit. As this effect is also highly sought after in other kinds of woodworking, I can also give you this as an example, which are my shellac covered bookcases. Shellac is a surface enhancement material, so to say, that is often used to create exactly that effect. I'm not saying that every pipe, or even every good or very good pipe, has a such a surface. Not even every good smooth surfaced pipe has or should have it. Take, for example, this 2011 Dunhill root briar, a pipe which is the one I'm smoking right now, and it is kind of a bit of my knock-around pipe, and the effect, it just isn't there, and that's not a consequence of the root briar finish. For if you look at this 1987 root briar, it almost seems like a perfect example, if you look at this, how it changes not only the shadow, but also the reflection, which seems to spread around under the surface in a very organic way. But even with the most excellent examples of that amazing, I find it amazing, effect, that shine that is required for that typical so-called wet look, for that three-dimensionality, that shine becomes somewhat dull as the pipe is smoked more often, the fats and oils from the fingers, not only mine, but human fingers in general tend to have that effect. They settle on the surface, and the effect, like in this case, though it's rather shiny still, it's somewhat more dull. There are many pipes that try to do away with that problem by coating the wood in not only in a certain finish, which is basically nothing but a color that highlights the structures and the visual quality of the wood and its grain, but they cover it additionally in a kind of lacquer, like this chacon. You can see it here, it's high gloss finish, and this won't go away even after smoking. It pretty much stays that way until there's really a layer of oil which has settled on the surface, but then it only needs a cleaning and no polishing. But covering a pipe in lacquer is a bit problematic, if you ask me, because it tends to restrain the breathing ability of the wood, and that, of course, is of the essence if you want to smoke the pipe actually and not only look at it. So what needs to be done with a pipe that does not go for that cheating solution, so to say, is just that you need to polish it. And there are different possibilities with which that might be done. Many German pipe smokers that I know are using Carnauba wax, or Carnauba wax, which they usually apply using a buffer, which is something I don't have. Being the Dunhill fanboy that I am, I've been using this for a number of years, which is basically a very simple polish. Oh, you see, it's a rather old one at that, but it still worked, and I was relatively contented with that. But I have recently discovered something that makes a great difference in many ways, and which also does produce a more lasting effect. It's something which my friend, pipe dealer and mentor, so to say, in all things tobacco, Samuel Goldberger of the finepipes.com website, came up with. These two waxes, Paragon and Halcyon II. He makes them blending together a microcrystalline and natural waxes in a way that produces a result that has a melting point, which is a lot higher than that of traditional waxes that are used on wood, which makes these perfectly apt for covering objects which tend to be as hot as pipes. I have found these two products to be very, very useful, and actually the results which I have produced using these have been quite amazing, and in many cases I didn't really, and that's no exaggeration, I didn't remember that my pipes were that beautiful and the surfaces had such depth to them. I will now show you how these two products are applied and used, because it's that simple. I can show it to you in a matter of seconds. Now, Paragon is more apt for smooth surfaces, while Halcyon seems to be more apt for rough finished pipes, sandblasts, and rusticated pieces. What you have to do is as simple as it can get. You put some of that wax on your finger. You can of course use a brush for that as well, and you cover the pipe, or rather the bowl of the pipe, with that wax. Now, the pipe doesn't only have a wet effect, it actually is wet, and you want to allow this to dry for about 30 seconds or so. When that has happened, you can add an additional layer and repeat that process, especially with a Paragon. That is a good idea. It enhances the effect, and again, you allow this pipe to dry for a bit, 30 seconds. When it's dry, you'll notice that the surface has become a bit sticky instead of wet. And when that is the case, you just take a piece of cloth and rub it off, more or less vigorously, depending on your mood, I suppose. And you do that for about as long as it takes. You'll notice the difference immediately. Make sure that you also polish the rim and the backside of the bowl here to make it perfectly even. And once that is done, you can marvel at the effect. Here you can see the same pipe in the same light as before. It really does make a difference. You get all those little details that you see here moving, as it seems nearly alive when moved against the light. You get that, all that comes out much better. I really can recommend those two waxes. Especially Paragon seems perfectly fitted to highlight the depth of the grain. And it, in a way, you know, it seems more like an enhancement of the natural glow of the surface texture and of the grain than an artificial enhancement. If you compare that, you will see here that the surface of this seems three-dimensional. The light is broken here. I don't know if you can say that or not, but you know what I mean. There are all different kinds of reflections on that, because you see the actual surface of the wood, and here you can see exactly the contrary. This seems as smooth as glass, and that's not the natural surface of wood. And this is why I actually prefer this solution, even if it means that I have to polish my pipes. Actually, it's become part of my daily ritual, so to speak, and it actually gives me something to do during boring conversations. Now, Halcyon too doesn't reach that level. On smooth surfaces, the effect is somewhat more matte than that of Paragon, but it is really better suited for rough surfaces onto which it might be applied using a small brush. That is actually a rather big one. I only wanted to show you the movement that I think is the best to apply it, but that's nothing but common sense, and I think you can figure it out on your own. Using, for example, a brush that is used for painting fingernails seems about the right size for that. But what really convinced me the most was that when the shine of the pipe is starting to dull down after the first few smokes, it can be very effectively brought back to splendor, so to say, by only polishing over the surface with a cloth, as you just saw me do. There is no necessity of applying a new layer of wax to re-establish that glossiness and that three-dimensionality, or that illusion. So the effect created by that treatment seems to be enhanced the more often the procedure is repeated, so that one's pipes actually get more beautiful as they get older, which I think is a worthy way of aging for pieces that we cherish as much as we cherish our pipes. For me, having such tools and such means really has significantly raised the delight that I feel when I look at my pipes. So if you want to give this a try, I think that's a very good idea. There is much more information on these waxes on Sam's website, which I'll, as so often before, link in the description bar below. And, well, I think that's about it for today. Thanks for joining me, and give this a try. I really think it's a good idea.